The Empty Pot, a musical play based on a traditional Chinese folktale.
Long ago, in a small village in China, there lived a boy named Ping. Like many people in China, Ping and his parents spent much of their time in the garden, growing beautiful flowers and vegetables.
Look, Mother, the melons are growing so well. I think they will be so sweet.
Yes, Ping, I agree. Did you try Snow Pea?
They are delicious, Mother.
Ping, you've taken such good care of our garden. You have a special gift. Everything you plant bursts into bloom.
Ping and his parents took much pride in their garden. Ping spent hours pulling weeds, watering the crops, and planting new seedlings. Everything Ping planted grew strong. Colorful flowers, round bushes, and tall fruit trees. They paraded into the palace, greeting their beloved emperor with a dance.
Thank you.
I'm sure I can help this seed grow into the most beautiful flower ever.
First, Ping covered the bottom of a small pot with stones and added the darkest, richest soil. He carefully pressed the seed about 1 inch below the surface and covered it lightly with soil. For the next week, he watered his plant every day, like all of the children across China, waiting for the first sign of a leaf to pop through the surface. A boy from Ping's village denounced his success first.
My seed has sprouted. I will surely be the winner now.
Father, I'm worried. Why has my seed not sprouted yet?
You must be patient, Ping.
I want to have the most colorful, beautiful flower, Father. I hope my seed begins to grow soon.
Weeks go by, and all over China, children brag about their success, showing off beautiful flowering plants. Another boy from a nearby village announced his success.
I knew it! This is a sign that my seed will grow to the biggest, most beautiful flower!
I can't be patient anymore. It has been almost a month, and my seed hasn't even begun to grow.
You still have time.
But what will the emperor say to me if I have nothing in my pot?
Do not give up, Ping. It will grow.
So Ping continued to do his best, watering the plant carefully, adding soil and nutrients, making sure that the plant had enough sunlight.
Please, little plant, grow. I have cared for you, watered you, given you the best soil. I do not know what else to do.
After 6 months, spring came. The sounds of baby birds chirping filled the air, and wind blew gently through the trees. It was time to go to the palace and meet the emperor.
Come, Ping. It is time to go to the palace.
Father, how can I go if I have nothing in my pot?
You've done your best, Ping. Your best is good enough to present to the emperor.
All the other children will laugh at me. I'm ashamed to take this pot to the emperor.
Take your pot to the emperor and tell him the truth.
Ping saw some village children as he began to leave his garden. All of the other children who were holding their flowering plants. When they saw Ping's empty pot, they joked and laughed.
Where is your flower? You can't go to the emperor with that.
How could you show up with an empty pot? You should have a big, beautiful plant like mine.
You should be ashamed. What would the emperor say to you with an empty pot? You should stay home.
As the children left, Ping, sad and ashamed, remembered his father's advice and decided to go to the palace anyway.
Children began to gather in the courtyard of the royal palace. Children from all over China walked into the palace grounds, carrying the most beautiful coloring plants. Ping's plant had still not grown, and he was the only one with an empty pot waiting to see the emperor.
The day has come. Today I shall crown the new emperor of China.
The emperor walked down the line, looking at each boy holding his colorful plant. He said nothing until he got to Ping. Everyone expected Ping to get punished for not being able to grow his plant.
Why have you come here with an empty pot?
Your Majesty, I have tried my best. I planted the seed you gave me. I planted it in the richest, darkest soil. I watered it carefully every day and kept it in a sunny place. It just would not grow. Today I bring you the empty pot. It was the best I could do.
I have found the new Emperor of China.
Everyone stood stunned. They couldn't believe that the boy with the empty pot won the contest. So the Emperor explained.
I needed to find a successor who was honest and trustworthy. I boiled all the seeds I gave you so none of them should have grown.
The children were shocked.
I do not know where all of these seeds came from, but Ping was the only boy who was honest. I admire his bravery to come to me with an empty pot. Because of his courage and honesty, I reward him with the kingdom and all of its beauties.
All of the children realized how important it was to be honest, and they congratulated the new Emperor Ping. They placed their flowers at his feet.
I am ashamed. When my seed did not grow, I planted a flower from my garden in the empty pot.
I bought a plant at the market because my seed would not grow. I should have been honest with the Emperor.
Ping, we should have not made fun of your empty pot because our seeds didn't grow either.
We were not kind or honest.
We are sorry for teasing you, Ping.
Where are Ping's mother and father? You have raised your son to be a caring, trustworthy person. He will serve the kingdom well as our new emperor.
We are so proud of you, Ping. 3 cheers for our new emperor, Emperor Ping. Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
The end. Introducing the technical crew, Jason. Yeah.